Many things in this life are confusing. Taxes, cryptocurrencies, how the Euronations League works, the continued popularity of Mrs. Brown's Boys. Few things, though, are as confusing as 70s and 80s TV quiz show 3-2-1. Here is its obscure computer game. What a looker. And here is a highlight, inverted commas, of the TV show.
What do we have in there? We have two pieces of eight. I would change them any day for that young piece over there, that piece of 16.
Pirates aboard!
3-2-1 was a British game show that ran from 1978 to 1988. It was based on a Spanish TV show called Un, Dos, Tres, Responda Otra Vez, or 1-2-3 Respond Again, which started in 1972 and ran way into the 2000s. The format was a real smorgasbord, not just a quiz show, but also a variety show with special guests and comedy regulars doing skits, all based on that week's distinct theme. It was hosted by Ted Rogers, a light entertainer known for his risky, flippy hand motion, which if done incorrectly would have seen them get a nice little meeting up with the folks at Ofcom. He was backed up by a bevy of beautiful hostesses, which is all very of its time now, I suppose, and a toy remote-controlled R2D don't called Dusty Bin. Look at that dumb face. Dusty Bin was the show's booby prize, representative of a brand new bin, one of those tin ones that they use in wrestling to hit each other. But actually, you might need a bin. If you need a bin, get in a time machine, go back to the 1970s and do really badly at 3-2-1. The show's first quiz was the 1,000-to-1 quiz, with each correct answer being worth a tenner. The questions would be some very poorly written word association things. If anyone knows about things that are really poorly written, it's me, as you've seen so far. Then there's an elimination to whittle down the couples competing, and then a truly baffling prize clue round, which closes the show and is truly, truly baffling. I'd like to explain it, but I've got something better to do, which is nothing at all. Just know it was tacky, disorganized trash, but also spectacularly popular. At its height, 3-2-1 attracted a truly astonishing 16.5 million viewers in its Saturday evening slot. So like all trashy 80 TV shows, naturally 3-2-1 did indeed have a ZX Spectrum game. However, 3-2-1 could not be found on the shelves of WH Smith's or Boots, as it was exclusively available via mail order. Yes indeed, if you fancied a copy of 3-2-1, you had to mail order it. Send a little clipping off in an envelope to receive this masterpiece of software design. But get this, unlike every other quiz game we've covered so far, from Countdown to Every Second Counts to The Krypton Factor to Bob's Full House, all have offered the quiz experience without one of the key, most intrinsic parts of a quiz, an actual prize, a real world honest prize. And how does a week in Spain sound? To win the prize, you would have to play the game, then send your score to Microcomputer Incorporated. This was allegedly not open to abuse, but people are people and they cheat, and I probably need therapy seriously for the amount of distrust I have in the general public. It was a Spectrum exclusive too, with a Commodore 64 game touted but never released, much to the great relief of Commodore owners. You see, 3-2-1 isn't very good. We've had some right stinkers on this channel recently, from Pink Panther to Postman Pat 3 and Popeye 3. But you know what? They've all been deeply flawed for a variety of reasons, but they have at least tried, sort of. They resemble computer games at least. This is most of the game. This screen here. A true or false set of questions. The same set that you'll get in every subsequent playthrough. It is, if I may use this term, one basic bitch. and it goes on forever. Well, seemingly. Is this an instrument? Is it? Yes or no? For excruciating deca-minutes of your life. Just gone. Leonardo DiCaprio has never wasted any time on this drivel, nor has Gal Gadot, nor has Gary from Reef. You know, that guy who used to say, "All right now." Is this actually my life now? Is this what I've come to? Staring at a blue screen telling a Spectrum emulator what an oboe is. What is life? What is the point anymore? Why do I continue to draw breath? Can I just go to sleep and never wake up? It seems like the better option. Yes, 321 will drag you into a deep depression and refuses to let you go until the next level. The next level is a platform game. A single-screen platform game where you must manoeuvre a couple up some clouds to the promised lands of prize-winning heaven. This is just like the show, this. I'm sure I remember this from the show, for sure. I'm not entirely sure which show, but I'm sure it's just like it. Your character can get crushed by the Claudio Nimbus, which ebbs away at your time, but at least you get plenty of it. Plenty of it to get frustrated at the god-awful responsiveness, but at least the lady is showing a bit of flesh here, eh? Look at those boobies. Well, at least I think she is, but I'm willing to fantasise about single pixel nipples, which I'm sure is actually probably just her underarm gap, than actually think about the horror of what I'm doing at the moment. I'm playing this wretched game. It is bad. Your Sinclair reviewed it in their issue 2. They said, "Assign this to Dusty Bin. It's so bad that the reviewer would rather have a season ticket to Highbury." I'm presuming he's not an Arsenal fan, an assumption probably correctly backed up by its rather generous, actually, 2 out of 10 score. Crash and Sinclair user, they didn't even sully their tape drives with this gack. It's no 3-2 fun. So a dismal end then to 2021 Spectrum games based on TV shows. Can Thomas the Tank Engine get us back on track in 2022? Probably not, but hope springs eternal, eh? But for now, K, thanks, bye.